Hello everyone. So in this video, I'll be showing you how to create multiple objects of a class in C++ using for loops. So let's get started. So currently I'm having here a sample code of a class named student. So let me just walk you through this code. So I'm having like three data members, which is like basically name, roll number, mark, the typical class student type. Okay. So I'm having a function void input just to get all those details as an input. So I'm having cin, name, roll number, mark, and I'm having a function to display those contents. So it's print. So basically we are printing the name, roll number, and mark. So really simple function, okay? So first let me show you how we will do this particular thing by using the old method or an individual objects method. So let's me just go and create an object of a class student, okay? So it's going to be class name, which is student, and let me put S1. So let me have two objects, S1 and S2, okay? That's fine. And first thing, how we will input, we will just put S1 dot input, okay? That's how we will input values. So let me do the same for another object S2 as well. So after inputting, what we will do, we will just display the output. So it's going to be S1 dot print. That's it. And same thing, we'll just copy this, paste it, and I will do the same. Okay, so let me just execute it now. So we need to input name, roll number, and mark. So I will put John. Roll number will put 20, mark I will put as 90, put Ravi 30, mark as 90 as well. So if I hit enter, I will be getting this like beautifully displayed because of my print function over there. Same because it's calling print too. I have called print using my object. So this is well and good. It works perfectly as you can see here. But the only problem by doing this way is that we need to do it manually. Like we need to define these things. So let's suppose say we have like 10 students. So we need to create 10 objects like S1, S2, S3, S4. Like it needs to be called, and this function should be repeated 10 times. So in order to like minimize that task, we will be using for loop and multiple objects. So to do that, it's really simple. Just delete all this stuff, or let me just comment this. Okay, so it will be better to get commented. We'll just comment it, and same thing. We need to create an array of objects. Okay, that's a really simple thing to create multiple objects. You need to create an array of objects. So same thing, how we will create array, we will put int arr and the square bracket. Same thing over here as well. Let's just put student, yes, and a square bracket. And inside the square bracket, what we will do for typical array, we will just pass the length of an array. So here let me pass, I will put 3. Let my length be 3. Same thing. Okay. So this means that I am creating an array of objects of type class student. Simple, same thing over here. Instead of creating like individual variables, we are creating an array of objects. That's it. So now next thing is we need to get the input of all these array of objects, that is S0, S1, S2. Okay, so how can we do that? We will do that by using our for loop. Okay, really simple. Just put a for loop int I equal to 0, I less than 3, I plus plus. And another important thing is that similar to array, it starts from 0, 1, 2. Okay. And now how can we like call? So it's S of I. Dot input. That's it. Really simple. So instead of writing this twice, we will put S of I, we will just iterate through that each object in the array, and we will just pass input. So how are we going to display, that is print the details? Same thing, just copy this, paste it over here, and just replace it by print. That's it. We are just removing this as an individual object. We are just converting it to an array of objects and just using for loops. Really simple. We have just converted easily. So let me just now run this code and show you. I hope it works. So here we are having like 3, S0, S1, S2. So we need to put 3. So let me put J, and I'll put 30, 100, K, I'll put 40 or something, 150, some random marks. Okay. L, I'll put 50 and 200. Let me just hit enter. So as you can see here, I am getting this name J3000K L5200. So it works, it really works. As you can see, I have just used same thing, same functions input. Okay, everything works perfectly. And you can ask me why I gave 3 over here, because I can't just keep on inputting more and more values. But here I have hard coded the value, like I am specifying the size of array directly itself. So the better way to do that is you can get the number of objects from the user itself. So that's also a really simple way. Okay, let me just put int n, which is the number of objects or a length of our object array basically. So let me put a cout. I will just put enter the number of objects and we just put endl. I'll put c in n, and instead of this 3 over here I'll put n, and here also n, and here also n. Okay, instead of hard coding we can even get the number of objects from the user. Okay, just save it and just execute it now. So it is the number of objects. I want 2, so let me put j 20 100 k 30 200. So that's it. It just works like magic. So you have just converted from this static individual object like repetitive code to like really efficient and short code with the help of multiple objects. Okay, really just a for loop can change entire thing, entire code. Okay, so I hope you have found this video useful. I have also done many other programming videos in C++ and C, as well as Java, Python, as well as 3D animation in Blender, as well as SQL query questions, as well as interview questions. So do check other videos on the channel, subscribe and support me for programming and other stuff. Thanks for watching.